To structure these N-tier applications, we're going to talk about one particular framework as an example. It's just as an example, there are other frameworks that provide similar functionality to the JEE framework, which is called the Java Enterprise Edition framework. And in the JEE framework, there are four containers for constructing an application service. And containers, you can think of as protection domains implemented typically in a Java virtual machine. In the JEE version of building N-tier applications, there are four containers. There is a client container, and there is an applet container for the client, which will reside typically on a web server. And this is the one that interacts with the browser on the end client. And the presentation logic that I mentioned to you earlier is provided in a container, which is called the web container. And this is the guy that is responsible for dynamically perhaps creating the pages that have to be sent by the web server back to the browser of the client. And there is an EJB container, which is the one that manages the business logic that corresponds to what needs to be done in order to carry out the request that has come in from the end client. And there may be a database server that the business logic is communicating with in order to get access to the data that it needs to process the request that came in. So these are the four containers, the client container, the applet container, the web container, and the EJB container, that are the containers that are available for packaging the objects that constitute the N-tier application for providing a particular service, for example, airline reservation service or a hotel reservation service. The key hope is that we want to exploit as much as possible reuse of components. And for this purpose, continuing sort of the coffee analogy starting with Java, the word bean is used to indicate a unit of reuse. That is a bundle of Java objects providing a specific functionality. For example, there may be a bean that provides the shopping cart function. So that becomes a unit of reuse in constructing an N-tier application. The containers that I talked about here host the beans. That is, a container allows you to package a whole bunch of Java beans and make it available in this container. In the JEE framework, there are four types of beans. One type of bean is called an entity bean. For instance, an entity bean may be a row of a database. If you think about the database holding employee records, for instance, one row of the database may correspond to all the employees whose last name starts with the alphabet A. And typically, entity beans are persistent objects with primary keys, and the persistence for the entity bean may be built into the bean itself, and that is what is called bean-managed persistence, or it may be built into the container into which that entity bean is instantiated. In either case, since we are dealing with objects that may need persistence, it is important that persistence for that object is handled somewhere, either in the entity itself or the container into which that entity is being hosted. The second type of bean is what is called a session bean, and the session bean typically is associated with a particular client and a particular session, meaning a temporal window over which a client is interacting with the service. That is what a session bean may be holding. And a session bean could be a stateful session bean, meaning, for instance, I am ordering, let's say, a computer by contacting a portal for Dell. In that case, the session that I'm establishing with the Dell portal, that session has to be stateful because it has to remember what choices I'm making. I may actually keep those choices alive, go away for a while, come back the next day and continue with my purchase. So sessions could be stateful. There could also be stateless session. For instance, if I start an email session using my browser with Google, using Gmail, that session may be stateless. I go away, everything that I did during that session can be thrown away because I'm going to start a brand new session when I reinitiate a connection with the Gmail server. So in that sense, a session bean could be a stateful session bean or a stateless session bean. And the third type of bean is what is called a message-driven bean. This kind of bean is useful for asynchronous behavior. For instance, I might be interested in getting the stock quotes. I might have a stock quote ticker on my browser, and I might want to get updates on the movement of stocks of a particular company that I'm interested in. And that would be something that is accomplished using a message bean, which is having this asynchronous behavior. Stock ticker is an example, news feed is an example, RSS feeds that you typically are using these days are examples of message-driven beans. And the finer we make these beans, each of these beans is denoting a functionality, but if you can have fine-grained versions of these beans, that gives a greater opportunity to enhance the concurrency for dealing with an individual request that's coming into your application server, or there could be concurrent requests. In addition to my own request, there could be parallel requests coming in. All of those can be dealt with more concurrently if we implement these beans at a finer level of granularity. But if you implement the bean at a finer level of granularity, that means that the business logic is also getting more complex. So there is always this trade-off in structuring N-tier applications that we may have a complex business logic in order to support finer grain concurrency, or you might choose to keep the business logic very simple and use coarse grain beans. And this is where the core of what we are going to discuss lies, and that is we are going to discuss different design alternatives for structuring such N-tier application servers.